Hi folks, Dr. Bob. I wanted to talk a minute about purified water or reverse osmosis, which is produced by reverse osmosis or distillation. I had a customer come in just recently and they said, hey, we've been drinking purified water, reverse osmosis for 20 years. And we're looking into water, ionized water, water ionizer, and they didn't know quite what it was. So I explained to them, alkaline ionized water and purified water are 100% exactly the opposite from one another. Purified water is not found in nature. And a lot of people say, well, rainwater is purified water. No, not even close. Because if you had pure water, you wouldn't have snowflakes, as an example. Now, you don't find purified water, H2O, a pure chemical substance, anywhere in nature. It doesn't exist. So when you see rain, it's got little particles in it. And then when the rain freezes, it turns into snowflakes, and it's the snowflakes that actually form around the crystals that are, or something's in the water, either particles or minerals or something. But the idea that you take rainwater and that's pure water is just nonsense. It's not true at all. You have to create purified water, pure H2O. Now, like if you put purified water, reverse osmosis, or distilled water into the freezer, it'll turn into these clear little cubes, okay? And they'll tinkle in your glass. And if you put regular water in there, well, it's kind of cloudy. Well, that's all the crystals that have formed inside the ice cube around the water structure. So there's minerals in there, calcium, magnesium, something like potassium maybe. Depends on what you water. It could even be sediment. But the crystals will form around that, and that's why that ice cube is cloudy. So purified water should never be consumed for the following reasons. Number one, it is pure, so it's going to leach minerals from your body, because any pure chemical substance that, you know, enters nature, or enters the world, whatever, it's going to want to bind with something else. It's going to mix. This is how tornadoes are formed. For instance, you got cold weather, and then you got hot weather, and then they form a tornado. And because the hot and the cold come together, and they don't know what to do, so they're going to meld with each other, and then you're going to get this tornado as a result. So that's how you know, things in nature always seek an equilibrium. So purified water, again, doesn't have that. And it's going to seek to equalize itself from your body. It's going to steal minerals, which are alkaline, calcium, magnesium, potassium, from your body and equalize out the water. And so it's stealing minerals from your body. It leaches them out. So you'll lose minerals over time. Also, way the water molecule clusters are structured is that they, in purified water, is that what we call pentagon. They're in a pentagonal five-shaped structure. There was a product out on the market years ago, maybe it's still out there, I don't know, called Penta Water. And that was purified water, and they were injecting it with oxygen, and people felt better drinking that. But once again, it's purified water, so Penta Water. And but that water molecule structure doesn't hydrate the body very well at all. So it leaves the body dehydrated. So that's number two. Why you shouldn't drink purified water, because it actually won't hydrate your body, it'll leave you dehydrated. It's also, number three, it is acid, it's acidic, so, you know, if you, it's part of the reason is because of pure, but it's going to have a pH below 7, and so it's acidifying your body. You want alkaline water, alkaline substances to raise the body pH up. And by the way, I wrote this book about this entire subject here called The Miraculous Properties of Ionized Water, The Definitive Guide to the World's Healthiest Substance, because there is no substance better for the human body than water, and there is no better water to consume than alkaline ionized water. So that's what the book I wrote. It's the third edition again, and it's also available on audible.com, so you can listen to it. But I cover every aspect of water you can think of. I started out in water when I was just a kid. My father was a groundwater expert. He had a PhD from MIT. He taught at Michigan State University, and he started an engineering company in Mason, Michigan called Wolverine Engineers and Surveyors. And I think it's still there as far as I know. And anyway, that's how I got this kind of this knowledge about water. I've just been around it my entire life. I've told several stories through the years about this, and why we want to drink one particular water as opposed to another. So ionized water, again, 100% the opposite of purified water, and minerals, the minerals in ionized water, you're really drinking ionized minerals. It's minerals that have been ionized, not the water itself, technically speaking, because again, you're creating these positive and negative ions out of the minerals that are in the water. So ionized water, alkaline ionized water, is water that has passed over positive negative electrodes, an anode and a cathode. It creates positive negative ions, and then those are separated through a membrane in the middle. So one side becomes alkaline, the other side becomes very acidic. The acidic water you don't consume, that's positively charged, and it's great for plant growth, it's great for your skin, it helps take out wrinkles, it's great for your hair, it's good pesticide, and any kind of cuts, scrapes, rashes, anything like that, very good for those, but it's not to be consumed. The alkaline water, which is the negative side of the water, that has three antioxidant qualities. It has a negative charge, negative ORP, oxidation reduction potential, that reduces the oxidation in your body, same as raw fruits and vegetables. Has an abundance of electrons in the water, so it's a free radical scavenger, just like raw fruits and vegetables, and it has an abundance of hydrogen, and we'll talk about that. I've been talking about that a lot because I have a water ionizer now that actually produces even more hydrogen in the water than before. It used to be, the typical one was around 500. We have one now that'll do 1300 parts per million. They're just becoming commercially available. We're trying to figure this out and how to really do this as far as how we're going to get it in there. Long story, I won't bore you with it now, but ionized water is got these small, they call it structured water, these really small water molecule clusters, and they're very, very tiny. They're hexagonal in shape. If you see anything in nature, it's always six-sided, hexagonal, meaning like, for an example, beehives. Okay, they're six. Snake skin is six. Insect eyes, it's six. Crystalline structures are six-sided. It's a, because this is the most efficient use of energy in the universe. The hexagon, it just collapses down to that. And the universe is always trying to use as little amount of energy as possible. It's just the way it goes. And you know, very frugal in that way, the universe. Thank you, universe. So at any rate, you have this water, this water molecule structure is six-sided. Well, it's very, very penetrating, it's very, very hydrating, it pushes out all the things that don't belong in our cells and our tissues, which we refer to as toxins. So it's extremely detoxifying, and this is pretty much the only kind of water I ever drink is alkaline ionized water, and for that reason. So, having said that, and of course it is alkaline, so it's got a high pH, and we always, all disease lives in an acid environment within the body and will not live in an alkaline or neutral environment when the body, within the body, and you look at cancer, you're very, very acidic. And so you want to HAD, hydrate, alkalize, detoxify the body. Those are the three keys to becoming healthy. I explain that all in my book. Again, available on Audible if you want to listen to it, or just go to Amazon.com or buy it from us directly off our website, DrBobMcCauley.com. I think I've explained this pretty carefully, you know, and just for the heck of it, why not I just add, ionized water, you're not going to really provide the body with more minerals, but you're certainly not going to have leaching of the minerals. So it's not about getting mineralized from alkaline ionized water or from spring water or from filtered tap water. It's about not having them stolen because it's already been balanced. So when you put purified water into the body, it steals those and it leaves you, you know, dehydrated, and it leaves you, you know, with less minerals, so it demineralizes the body. Minerals are the keys that start the engines of our health. So I think I've explained that pretty carefully and pretty thoroughly. If you need more help, look at my book. Or comments in the below would help. And anyway, that's the difference, and that's why you should never drink purified water, reverse osmosis, or distilled, and why you should always drink alkaline ionized water, the healthiest water we can possibly consume. Dr. Bob. Stay healthy. See you guys next time. I just want to remind you to buy my books. I've got 8 books on natural health, 1 on cancer, 1 on silver, 1 on water, some other ones. I've been writing books now, believe it or not, 25 years. And go to Amazon.com or Audible. I've got them all on Audible. Or go to BobMcCauleyBooks.com. But buy my books, please, and review them.